wish I had a quarter for every time someone told me how strong I was. I don't want to be strong.
Let it out, Reba. Let it all out. Everything will be okay. That was. We both do.
Okay, a little more to the left. No, 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 your other left. This is the fourth time you've had us do this. It's fine. I want it to be perfect. Everything has to be perfect for Shane. Okay, you heard the woman. A little more to your left, Joey.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, if Mara ever opts out of the fashion business, she'll be a great drill sergeant.
Yeah, she's definitely the one in charge around here, that's for sure. She's going to take good care of her brother.
Oh, I'm sure she's going to take good care of her brother, but it must have been a little difficult to have him come here instead of coming home with you and Reba.
It was his choice, Ross, that's it. I just feel lucky that he's letting me be in his life right now, that's all.
Okay, he's here, he's here.
Hey. Weather report from the day Lori Jensen was murdered.
So our anonymous caller was right. There was a hell of a thunderstorm that night. Would you take your boat out in the middle of weather like that?
Sure, if I had a death wish.
Yeah, but what if your wish came true already? Brad Green takes his boat out in the middle of a thunderstorm.
They weren't fishing.
Yeah, what if they were trying to lose someone? Or someone like Lori Jensen? It's me again. Any word from Harley? Check on the kids or? No? Okay. Well, did she say where she was going tonight? No, I'm just curious. All right. Thanks. Harley, you better not be with this creep.
Mr. Green. I'm sorry, we must have gotten our signals crossed. I thought we were meeting at company. That's all right, I'll just lock up and we can talk while we go.
You have me where you want me, Ms. Cooper. You've been hounding me for days. Let's get this over with.
Actually, I think better on a full stomach.
Order in, then. I'm not taking this meeting in a public place.
Come on, my treat.
Or maybe we can have your dad pick up the check. He owns the place, right? And maybe your chief of police brother and your cop boyfriend might just be there having their usual.
You do your homework.
Very good.
Well, so do I, Mr. Green. And I have a few questions to ask you.
About Lori Jensen and the lie that I'm the one that got her pregnant. Well, this is your chance to hear what I have to say, Miss Cooper. We're gonna have our little meeting right here. One on one. Take it or leave it.
Reba, I am so sorry.
No, no, Christopher, I'm sorry.
No, you were vulnerable. You were looking for comfort from a friend, and I took advantage. I acted on my feelings for you, and that wasn't right. Ever since my wife died, I closed the door on everything and everyone but my work. And then you came along. And you opened the door.
I didn't mean to.
No, it's not a declaration. Please. I'm so sorry for the way it came out, but I am not sorry that you broke through and touched me.
I'm grateful for that.
I feel terrible about this. I do. I mean, you've been such a great friend to me, and then I pulled you into this drama.
I'm an adult. I can deal with this.
I was looking for something, I guess. A way out. I didn't turn to you because I needed comfort. I turned to you because I'm a coward.
I know this must be overwhelming for you, son, but everybody's just happy to have you here.
Actually, we just really needed an excuse to throw a party.
Where's my name on that sign? Because as I recall, I moved in today, too.
Enjoy the party while you can, Shane, because we are going to work you like a dog, starting tomorrow.
I'm getting extra credit for this.
Just kidding.
Well, it's not all going to be work. I mean, every night is movie night. Isn't that what you said, Laura?
Oh, yeah, that's right. But don't worry, Dad. You will get plenty of rest. You're going to have a 9 o'clock kit for you.
Work. Curfews. Big excitement, buddy. You're better off in the hospital.
What? This is going to be fun. This is going to be a blast. Right, Shane?
Sounds like it's going to be way too much fun around here, guys.
Fun? Shane has a lot of hard work to do. Shane, this is your nurse, Pam Mansfield. Now, she is the toughest, but she's also the best. She comes very highly recommended. I love you, too.
It's nice to meet everyone, and if it's okay, I'd like to check out Shane's room.
Sure, it's just right down
there. I'll show you where it is.
I'll help.
I can't believe you hired such a babe.
Well, she is the best. We're lucky to have her.
Yeah, we're real lucky, all right. Aw, he says he only sees me.
Hey, why didn't you offer to help out Nurse Hattie?
I didn't know your dad was going to be here.
Yeah, but you're off the clock. I'm sure he's glad that you're here.
Your mom going to be here, too?
No, she'll be here tomorrow. Why? Oh, that's right. You've never met my mom, have you?
Hi, Sandy. I have to leave for a few minutes.
No, you can't.
Well, here's the thing. I packed up some of Shane's stuff, you know. I thought maybe I'd bring it over here so he would feel more at home, but I left the box at the office, so...
Okay, well, that is a very good idea, but I think you should just hold off till tomorrow. I think that it is good that you're here for Shane, especially since Mom's not.
If I may interject, I'd be happy to get the box for you, Mr. Lewis.
Well, if that's okay, that would be great. Thank you.
It's done.
Okay.
Blake, that's the third time you've checked your voicemail. What's wrong?
What makes you think anything's wrong, really?
Blake.
I'm waiting for Harley to call, okay?
Okay, now I'm worried. What are you up to?
Oh, it's nothing. I mean, no big deal. It's just your
really?
Basic interview.
Really?
I would just feel better if she checked in with me. That's all.
Car's ready to roll, Detective. Unless you want someone to drive you.
No.
You really do need someone to be your partner.
Yeah, well, partners slow me down, you know.
No, I got it. I'm going to go down to the lake and see if I can figure it out. You know, if anybody saw Brad Green take the boat out or find out who the anonymous caller is, you know.
Hey, are you absolutely positive that Harley didn't call at all?
Yeah. Everything okay with her?
Yeah. Everything's fine. Take care of yourself.
You know what? You're absolutely right. Let's just dive in. You can start by
No. I make the rules here. You're not a cop anymore, remember? You're just a PI taking money from some poor woman to trash me around town.
That woman is Lori Jensen's mother. She believes you may be responsible for her daughter's disappearance. I'm just trying to bring her daughter home. You have a couple of your own, don't you?
My children are innocent. Lori Jensen wasn't. She was ambitious. She was only out for herself. We had an affair and it ended and that was it.
Well, if you had already moved on, how can you be so sure she wasn't pregnant?
Because I knew her. She was just out for her own career. She cared about her career more than me. That was the last thing on her mind was a baby.
must have been terrible for you dealing with a woman like that.
I wasn't all that invested.
Really? Because I was thinking maybe you were the one who wanted more out of the relationship. Maybe you were even willing to leave your wife for Lori. And she said no. And that's when you began to feel threatened by her independence.
It's a terrible thing to feel threatened, isn't it?
Look, Mr. Green, let's not turn this into something that it isn't. Okay? I just want a few answers from you. That's all.
All you want is to solve a big case.
No, that's not it. And come on, you're not this kind of man.
You have no idea what kind of man I am.
Well, then, why don't you tell me?
Why should I tell you anything? Because of you, my whole life, my career, my family, everything is hanging by a thread.
No, that's because of you. Because of your affair with Lori. But I don't care about that. I don't care how you conduct your love life. I just care that there is an innocent woman missing.
Oh, innocent, please. Lori Jensen was ambitious. I was just a rung on the corporate ladder for her. She got what she wanted. She got her promotion. What did I get?
Okay, well, why didn't she stick around long enough to enjoy that hard-won promotion? That's the thing I don't understand.
Nothing she did anybody understood. You don't know what it's like to be trapped. To know that everything you've worked so hard for all this time is lost in one stupid moment. To know that your life has been taken out of your hands.
You're wrong. Mr. Green, you're wrong. I know exactly what that's like.
Reva, you are many things, but you are not a coward. I've never seen you be anything but brave.
Except when it comes to dealing with my family.
You didn't go see Shane today because you didn't want him to see the tension between you and his father.
So much for me and my big, noble gestures. Hey, almost everybody bought it. Everybody except Billy.
What do you mean?
Well, Billy. He just knows me too well. This isn't the way it's supposed to be for Shane. You know, he's supposed to be on that ball field. He's supposed to be taking his girlfriend out to dinner. Instead, he may never walk again.
Oh, come on. You don't know that.
I'm his mother. I'm the one that's supposed to tell him everything is going to be fine. But how can I do that when I don't believe it myself? I can't let him see that in me. I can't let him see me like this. I'm just so weak.
You are way too hard on yourself.
I should have more faith.
You should have more faith in yourself. Just because you're scared for your son doesn't mean you won't be good for him.
He deserves better.
He has so much. He has his father, his sister, he has you.
You're not listening to me. He doesn't have me. Look what I did tonight. I ran. I ran away from seeing him, from facing Josh, because that's what I do. I ran straight to you, and that's why what happened between us almost happened. I thought I'd stop running.
I wasn't around for your other mistakes, but you did not make one tonight. Somebody said that courage is not the absence of fear, it's what you do in the presence of it.
And look what I did.
What you almost did. You walked right up to the line and you stepped back. That's courage.
Don't shrink me, Doc.
I'm not your shrink, I'm your friend. We're still friends, aren't we? Good. Reva, it's what you do now that counts.
Yeah? Well, then I'm in big trouble. Because you know what I feel like doing right now? Having a big bourbon and branch. Maybe two. But I'll settle for some ice cream.
That sounds good. Let's go.
You know, I've been meaning to ask you, how's your dad handling all this?
I mean, he's
He's trying. He had a pretty rough time dropping me off this morning. Yeah, I think he and my grandpa are staying away tonight just to prove that they can let go. I'm sure they'll be by tomorrow, though. Probably the next day, too, and the next day, so.
Right, right. I'll have to give him a call.
Yeah. Yeah, you should do that. You're probably the one person who can understand some of the things he's worried about right now.
Misery loves company.
Something like that. We're gonna be fine here, though. Shane and I both love this place so much. You know Shane is really happy to be here.
Yeah. I know. It's
gonna be a good thing.
I know it is. I believe that. There's just some things that I'm worried about, you know. Equipment. I don't know if we have enough equipment for what he's
got
to
deal with. We've got it covered, Mr. Lewis. I mean, I can give you a tour of everything if
you
like.
No, you don't have to do that. It's, you know, his recovery is not going to be just physical. It's going to be emotional. He's going to get angry.
And he's going to get bummed out. Yeah, we had to take psych classes about this along with PT. I know I might not know how he's feeling, but my mom stops by all the time, so if you think it's a good idea for her to talk to Shane.
It sounds like you have everything under control. Thank you.
You know he needs you too, Mr. Lewis.
Thank you.
Excuse me. Josh, I'm worried about you. Where's Reva, by the way?
She's gonna be here tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Yeah. Yeah, we're not really together right now, so we're sort of trading off with Shane. Tomorrow's her day, and it's okay though. It's fine. I'm fine.
Oh yes, yes, yes. Of course you are.
Okay, I'm not fine, but Reva still needs her time. So.
He looks really happy to be here with you. Yeah. I don't know. I hope I'm doing the right thing here. I'm not, you know, pushing him into this. I mean, maybe he should be with his parents.
Oh, listen. Reva and Josh understand what's best for Shane. It's you. You know, they went through a lot when Josh... But Ross told me. Reva was the one who literally got him to walk up on his feet. It's all about love, sweetie.
Josh, I know this is none of my business, but...
Well, no, it's not, actually.
But I am not going to let this go, all right? Now, you and Reva are going through something that's incredibly difficult. Now, you need each other to lean on each other, get strength from each other. You know that.
Yes, I do know that. It just can't happen right now. It's just, it's bad right now.
What?
Hey.
Hey.
Everything okay?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So do you mind if we took off? I'm sorry, but I have some really important business to take care of with the Angels.
I really appreciate you both being here. With you guys here, I'm not the only one here that's over 25 years old. That's a good thing. And I also do want to say thank you so much for whatever you did to get through the red tape we needed to get through, you know, so we could build the wheelchair ramp out there.
You're welcome. It's my pleasure. And if you need anything else done on the legal end, you call me. You understand?
I will. Thank you.
Bye, sweetie. Mm-hmm. Bye-bye.
Be fine. Take care. Hey, you guys, Blake and I have to run. Good to see you all. Good to see you.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you for coming.
So do you still think Harley's in trouble?
I just think that the man that she is with is trouble.
Uh-huh.
She'll be okay. She can take care of herself.
Let's go check it out.
Oh, wait a minute. It's probably her. Hey.
Blake, it's Gus.
Oh, hi, Gus.
Look, I really need to know where Harley is, okay?
You're her fiancé, don't you know?
Well, I wouldn't be asking you if I knew. I need to know because I found out some information on Brad Green, and she needs to know this before she makes contact with him, unless, of course, she's already made contact with him.
Wait a minute. No, I know what you're doing here. You're afraid that Harley's going to get to the bottom of this case before you do, because you know what? I know all about your bet, Ituro, and I know that you've already cheated.
Blake, I don't care. I don't give a damn about the competition, okay? I only care about Harley. So, listen, I'm just thinking she could be in some danger here.
The only thing Harley's in danger of is losing to you, and I'm not going to be responsible for that.
Blake. Blake!
I had everything. And I made a mistake. I did something I can't take back. And now, you don't know.
Now it's killing you. Well, obviously, holding on to it hasn't worked for you. So why don't you try letting it go? Just let it out. Maybe I can help you.
Don't you hear that? That could be your chance.
My chance?
Yeah. To prove that you're on my side. If you don't pick it up, you might hear the truth that you're so desperate for. On the other hand, if I'm a cold-blooded killer, it might be your last chance to save yourself. What's it gonna be? Pick up, Harley. Pick up, pick up, pick up. Go ahead. Pick it up. It's your lifeline. Tell whoever it is you're in the hands of a killer.
Come on, baby, pick up. Pick up the phone.
I just want the truth.
Thank God.
You have reached Harley's Angels. Please leave a message and one of us will get back to you.
If you're there, pick up the phone. All right, listen. It's about Brad Green. You were right. This guy is dangerous. So you stay away from him. You hear me? You just stay away from him. You let me handle this one, right, baby? Ah, the cop boyfriend. He's a real Prince Charming. Come on, what's it gonna be? Tell me you believe me over him. Let's see you do your job.
Why shouldn't I believe you?
You had your chance to pick up the phone and you didn't.
I can call him back. You are my top priority right now.
You're good.
I've been where you are. I have. Up against a wall, I've been there.
It's not the same.
You said you feel like everything you love is on the line. Well, I have faced death up close, and when I came out the other side, I made a choice to give up something I love for something I love more. My children, being with Gus.
You did what you had to do for your family. You made a sacrifice.
We all make sacrifices, don't we? But I still have a job where I can help people. I can help you.
Sure you can. You know, you almost had me believing that you care about me, but you're pretty good at fooling people, aren't you? Something we have in common.
I meant everything I said. I can help you. All you have to do is tell me what happened. Just tell me what happened.
What's that? You set me up!
Set you up. I didn't even know you were coming.
I don't
here.
Know how you did it, but they're coming and I gotta get out of
no,
here.
No, I didn't call the police.
You are
I didn't
coming
know that...
with me, Miss Cooper.
Not here? Well, maybe the interview got canceled. She went to check on Maureen and Shane.
You know what? It's not like Harley to not check in with me. I should have been there with her. We didn't want to spook this guy. He's seen me before.
Well, jumping to conclusions is not going to help anybody.
Hey, have you seen Harley today?
Mm-hmm. Anybody come looking for her?
Just you.
No. Was there an older, tall gentleman, handsome, kind of in a potentially psychotic kind of way?
Nope. Sorry, I didn't see anyone like that.
That's you. Look, let's just try this one more time, all right, Blake? I am not trying to get you to betray your loyalty to Harley. Okay? No, I got a tip on Brad Green that might put him with Lori the day of the murder.
What do you mean?
Let's just say the tip makes him look damn guilty, okay? And that is all I can say right now.
Harley was supposed to meet Brad Green at company tonight. I'm here right now, but...
Okay, I'm on my way.
Wait a minute, Gus, she never made it here. Gus... have been there with her. This is terrible.
What's the matter? What did Gus say?
My best friend may have kept a date tonight with a killer.
I really just need to do something normal.
Well, bring on the ice cream.
Can we have two of those really fabulous company coolers?
Make that one. I'll just have coffee, please.
Oh, come on. You're really not going to let me do this alone.
I have to keep my wits about me.
Two spoons, please.
You want to say hello to your friends?
No, they look busy.
They look like they just came from a party. Shane's party.
I thought I was the one who was psychic. Hi.
Hey, Reva.
Hi. How is my boy?
Oh, he's good.
I mean, it was great. It was, Oh, Reva, I want to tell you all about it, but I have an emergency I have to take care of. So can you just excuse me for just for a minute?
Sure.
Yes. How was Shane?
When he first got there, I believe he was somewhat overwhelmed.
What do you mean, overwhelmed?
It was a lot to deal with. I mean, coming home, but then again, not really coming home. Being in a wheelchair. But then everybody gathered around him, you know, picked him up, and Josh was just great with him.
Well, that's good.
Reva, you should be there with him. I mean, I know that you and Josh are going through a tough time, but Shane needs you, and you need him.
Well, I'm glad that Josh was there for him.
You take care. Oh, Shane.
I guess he's great. You know, everyone's taking really good care of him.
And how are you?
I don't know.
Here you go. Here's that extra spoon.
Thanks.
We have to find Harley. Let's look at the office, okay?
Hey, where is she?
I don't know.
What do you mean? Don't mess with me, okay?
I'm not messing with you. I wish I were.
Just tell me where she is.
I don't know.
I think we've established that Blake doesn't know where she is, so let's go looking for her.
I don't understand. Where are we supposed to look? She's supposed to be here. What happened to her meeting with Green right here?
She never made it here, according to the waitress. We're about to go to the office to check.
No, I called the office. If she was at the office, she would have answered the phone.
Gus, maybe she couldn't answer the phone.
All right, you guys go to the house. Maybe she'll be there. Maybe she'll call. I'll go to the office.
If this guy took Lori Jensen, what's one more missing girl to him?
She licked the pig.
Oh, man.
Hey, that's good. That was good, right?
That was excellent. Oh, very funny.
You like
it? Thank you very much for bringing this stuff here.
No problem, sir.
Yeah, Dad, this is really good stuff.
Yeah, you know what, though? I'm looking at it now and thinking, it doesn't belong here.
Why? It's Shane's.
Because it's from his old life, you know, and he's got a new life now. New goals, a new place to live, a fresh start, all that. I think I have to respect that. I just don't think it's going to work here.
Mr. Lewis, I think Shane wants to keep that stuff. Well, then I will unpack it for you. Don't you be expecting this kind of treatment when you're back on your feet, Lewis.
And I'll help. I don't mind.
Okay. Oh, my mom's still out of town, so I need to get home to take care of my little brothers.
And I'll drive you. And I have still a few more adjustments to make on your system. We've got it rigged so that you can audit classes at the university.
Wow.
Or you can watch girls going wild in Cancun on a continuous loop.
Yeah, not so much, no.
I tried.
Not so fast.
What, I thought we were going.
Well, yeah, after you talked to Shane, you haven't said more than two words to him since you got here.
Yes, I did, okay? I'm not so good at this talking thing. You should just talk baseball.
Okay, so talk baseball. Just talk. She's right. Shane needs some normal guy stuff. Look at my dad.
Well, I think I've driven everybody here crazy. No surprise there. But I'm convinced that you have everything that you need, so... you don't? Well, what else do you need? I mean, tell me what it is. I'll get it for you. You? Me. You need me. Thank you. You have me all the time, son. And your mom, too. She's gonna be here tomorrow, okay? So you have fun. I love you, Shane.
You guys, Shane wanted me to tell you thanks for coming and for everything.
Now all it needs is Shane.
Oh, you're gonna put him to bed?
I'm stronger than I look.
Well, so am I. I'd really like to tuck him in, if that's all right.
I'll come in a little while to check on you. You see the way she loves my brother? What you got there?
Hey, who's the, little boy? Doesn't look like Shane.
Of course it's Shane. Who else would it be? You know what? It's been a long day, and I'm sort of...
You must be exhausted.
No, actually, just the opposite. I was thinking about going over to the Beacon, having some coffee. You're really great today, and I'd like to get out of here. Earth to Sandy.
Yeah, there's nowhere else I'd rather be today. Coffee, yes. Let's do it.
Wonderful.
Yes.
So, do you feel better now?
Oh, of course. Everything is just so fabulous now. You really have to have some of that.
No, thanks. I'm okay.
What, so now this? With you?
What?
This awkwardness between us because of what happened. You know what? I don't think having a bite of my ice cream counts as an intimate gesture, so... Unless you are lactose intolerant. Friends don't let friends cry in their ice cream all alone.
Okay. I guess you're right.
That's good.
You know.
What?
Friends also tell friends when they have chocolate sauce on their nose.
I don't. I do. Where? I get it?
No.
Well, where? Where is it? Would you get it,
here,
please?
Here, 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 here.
Thank you.
Reba, what is it?
Nothing.
Threatening image?
No. No, it was nice. It was more than nice. To be held. You know, it's the chocolate. The chocolate is going right to my head.
Reva, it's all right to want to be held. Especially with everything you're going through.
Just since the accident, I've pushed Josh away. I've been pretty much pushing everyone away. So I haven't been held or